In this video, it's mixed practice. We simplify all of these problems having to do with complex numbers. This is part 8 of complex number. We're just going to practice simplifying with complex numbers since we've now done simplifying, adding, subtracting, multiplying, and dividing. So let's start with these three problems. Pause the video and try these, and write the answer in standard form, a plus bi, or if it's a real number, just write the real number, or a pure imaginary, just write the pure imaginary number. Okay, let's start with number one here. All right, in both of these, I have a negative number under the square root, so I want to rewrite that as I times the square root of 20, and then I'm going to write that as 4 times 5 underneath the square root. And over here, I have 5i. Also, because of the negative number of the square root, I could take an I out and write the square root of 18. I'm going to write 18 as 9 times 2. Okay, so from the under the first one, I could take a 2 out. And out of the second one, I could take out a 3. And also, notice in the second one, I have an I squared. Just keep that in mind. So let's see, what do we have here? On the outside, I've got negative 3 times 2, so that's negative 6i times the square root of 5. Negative 6i times the square root of 5. And remember, you can put the I at the end of the square root. Just make sure it's not underneath the square root symbol. And over here, I've got 5 times I squared. That, remember, that means 5 times negative 1. So that's negative 5 times 3. So that's negative 15. Square root of 2. So the second term here is the real part. So I write that first, negative 15, square root of 2, and then the negative I square root of 5 I write second. And I'm going to write that with the I at the end, negative 6 square root of 5 with the I at the end, or you could leave the I right in front of that square root. So that's problem number one. All right, here's problem number two. This is a multiplication problem. We start out the same. Anytime we have a square root of a negative number, we take out an I, so that's 5i square roots of 3, and this is 2i square roots of 6. All right, now I've got positive numbers under both square roots, so those could be multiplied together, and on the outside, I've got 10i squared. So 10i squared, and the square root of, let's do this on our head, 3 times 6 is 18, so I'm going to write that as 9 times 2. So square root of 9 comes out as a 3. So what do I have now? Well, I've got this I squared. So that's 10 times I squared. That's negative 10 times 3. So that gives me a negative 30 square roots of 2. And that's problem number 2. All right, problem number 3. We need to begin by, again, at the denominator, we've got to take out that I, when you have a negative 8 underneath it. So this is going to be the square root of 45. Well, we could simplify square root of 45. Remember, that is 9 times 5. And we could take an I out of the denominator. And what else is going on here with that 8? That could be thought of as 4 times 2. So out of the numerator, I could take a 3 out of the square root, because that's the square root of 9. So I have 3 square roots of 5. And in the denominator, I could take a 2 out, because that's the square root of 4. So I've got 2, and I'm going to write this as square root of 2. I'm going to write I at the end over here. Okay, now, notice in the denominator, we have a square root of 2, and we have an I. Remember, both of those are irrational. So I need to get rid of both of those. So I need to multiply the numerator and denominator by square root of 2i to get rid of both of the square root. We learned that when we were rationalizing denominators with square roots, and I have to multiply it by I to get rid of the I in the denominator, so I have an I squared. All right, so what do I have on the top? I've got 3 square root of 10i, or you could put the I in between the 3 and the square root of 10. All right, now what do I have on the bottom here? I've got this 2, okay, and I also have a square root of 2 times the square root of 2. That's another 2, right? So I have 2 times 2, which is 4, times my I squared, which is negative 1, right? And the way I could deal with that negative 1 is I could just move it to the front. Usually I don't leave minus signs in the denominator, so I have minus 3 square roots of 10 over 4i. Now it looks like a pure imaginary number. We hadn't done one quite that complicated before, but now we're sort of stretching the concepts using all of our resources. Here are 5 more problems for you to try, so put the video on pause and try these. Alright, here's the first one to try. This is just a subtraction problem, so we're going to first distribute the minus sign, minus 6 and plus 3 square roots of 2i, and then we're going to combine the like terms, which really in this case just mean the real parts and the imaginary parts. So 8 minus 6 is 2, and a negative 2i plus a 3 square roots of 2i is, well, remember that's negative 1 square roots of 2, so that'll be a plus 2 square roots of 2i. So that's the first one. Second one, this is a multiplication problem. And you might have noticed that these were complex conjugate. That would be the easiest way to do that problem. Since they're complex conjugates, you just square the A term. Now, so that's going to be 3 square roots of 2 times 3 square roots of 2. So that will be 9 times 2, because a 3 squared is 9, and the square roots of 2 squared is 2, plus the 4 times 4, which is 16. So that gives me 18 plus 16, or 34. Okay, now we're squaring something, so I'm going to write this out. So it's 4 minus square roots of 5. Oops, it didn't look very good. 4 minus square roots of 5i times another 4 minus square roots of 5i. These are not conjugates. So we've got to do the FOIL. 4 times 4 is 16. The outer is minus 4 square roots of 5i. The inner is another minus 4 square roots of 5i. And the last term is square root of 5i times square root of 5i. Well, that's going to be plus 5i squared. Now, what's 5i squared? That's negative 5. So I really have 16 minus 5, which is 11. And then for my two middle terms, that's the imaginary part, negative 8 square roots of 5i. So there's that one. All right, now we're dividing. Now we have a complex number in the denominator of the form a plus bi. So to deal with that, you need to multiply by the complex conjugate. So the conjugate of 6 plus 2i is 6 minus 2i. So you need to multiply both the numerator and denominator by 6 minus 2i. Okay, now what's that going to give me in the denominator here? Well, when you do conjugates, it's 6 times 6, 36, plus 2 times 2, which is 4, so I'm going to get 40 in the denominator. Let's see. That's not going to cancel with 3. But actually, if I factor the 6 minus 2i, it will cancel. But what I'm going to do is go ahead and distribute the 3 and then factor. That might be easier for most people. So 3 times 6 is 18 minus 6i. But you have to factor the numerator to see if it cancels with that 40. So I'm going to factor a 2 out, and that gives you 9 minus 3i over 40. And now the 2's cancel. I mean, I'm sorry, 2 goes into 40 20 times. So I end up with 9 minus 3i over 20. Almost done. Write it in the form a plus bi, 9 20ths minus 3 20ths i. I think we're going to make it. One more problem. I to the 39th, powers of i. So we want to think of this. There's the shortcut and the long way. First of all, that's the same thing as I to the 36 times I cubed. Remember, we're thinking of how many times 4 goes into 39, and that would be 9, and so that could be written as I to the 36th times I cubed. Why do we want to do it with the power of 4? Because then I could write it as I to the 4th to the 9th power. Oops, not equals. And I cubed is the same as I squared times I. So this is 1 to the 9th, right? times, because I to the fourth is 1, I squared is negative 1. So we have 1 times negative 1 times I, and that's going to give you a negative I. Now, the shortcut method is you go straight to I to the 39th is just going to be I cubed, because you know this I to the 36 is going to end up being 1. And there you go. We've done all sorts of different types of problems with complex numbers. You could just keep on working at it till it just seems as simple as adding 2 plus 3.